Hi, welcome to Maths Nipuna, your maths buddy. Question 17. Mary put the same amount of liquid in three rectangular vessels. We have rectangular 1, 2, 3. This one is medium, this one is very high, this one is very low. Okay, the liquid. But she put same amount of liquid. Okay, she put here, here and here, same amount of liquid. But when we see from front view, this one we see as very high, lot of liquid. This one looks like a medium, this one is a lowest. Okay. Viewed from the front, they seem to have the same size, but the liquid has risen to different level in three vessels. Which of the following represent three vessels when viewed from above? So just now we view from front. Okay. We have three vessels. If view from front, now we want to view from on top. Okay, that means these three vessels is a three dimensional, looks like this. Okay, we have this is the middle one, this is the highest, this is the lowest. So that means these vessels are like this. So we put the same amount of liquid into all the three, but this is looks very high. Okay, this is very high, and then our length should be at the lowest. Okay, then only it can be very go very high. Okay, if this is very low, that means this must be the length must be the highest. That's why this one looks very low. But this is medium, we can say this must be in between this and this. Okay, now we look at from top. Okay, so we can see this one is the medium one. Okay, this one is the smallest one. We see from here to here, this is the smallest, and this is the highest. Okay, so answer should be A. Okay, this is the smallest, middle, and then this is the highest. Okay, this you have to imagine in 3D view. Okay, we look at question 18 now. Okay, what does the object look like when viewed from above? So this question is something similar to question 17. Okay, so they give you a side view and they ask you to imagine the top view. Okay, this one, let's say you want to. No, okay, maybe we can see the there's a hexagon on top. Okay, there's a two hexagon we have. Okay, I just draw like this, and then we have another hexagon. Okay, this is two hexagon. Okay, we have like this, correct? Okay, we have like this. Okay, now we look at this hexagon. Okay, let's say when this is black, okay, I say this is black. Okay, this is also black. Then I use a black pen. And this is black, this is also black. Okay, and then this is black. Okay, then this is black, this one is gray, and then this is black, and then this is also black. Where is black? This one gray, this is black down one, bottom one, then the top one also black, this is also black. Okay, so this is our diagram now. So from this diagram, we have to find which one is suitable with this one. Okay, if you look at here, let's say black and black is here, I turn it a little bit so that I can get, okay, now black and black. Okay, so I bring it here. Okay. Black. Okay. Black. This also black. This is gray. This is gray. Here also black. Here also black. This is 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 gray. This is black. Okay. Okay. This is black. This is gray. So A cannot be. A is out. Okay, A is out. Okay, next look at B. We can start from black. Okay, black is somewhere here. A is okay. Turn it. Correct. The black is here. The black and then gray is here. This is black. This is black. Okay, this is black. This is black. And then this one black. This one black. Correct. Gray, correct. Black, correct. Gray. Okay, this looks correct. Okay. So what we do, we go to C. Okay, we assume B is a correct answer. Anyway, we test with C. Okay, C don't have something like this. I'm focusing on black, gray, like this. Okay, this is black, gray. So in C, we don't have up and down black and sides are gray. So C is out. Okay. Then D. D also, we don't have black and gray. Eh? Top and bottom black, sides are gray, don't have. So D also is not answer. A is not answer. And then look at E. Okay, E also we don't have black, gray. So E also out. So the answer is B. So that is the correct answer. The others all cannot be here. Yeah? This is how you have to imagine. Okay, when you accept. Okay. Okay, look at question 19. Three small squares are drawn inside a large square. So this is first square. This one is the second square. And then it comes the third square. It's drawn inside the large square. This is the large square. What's the length of the line mark with question mark? So they ask you to find this length. Okay, so this is a square, so we know that for a square, side and the width are both sides are same. That means your length and width are same. So if this is 28, this length is 28. From here to here must be 28. Okay, if this is 28, so this should be from here to here should be 28 minus 15, which is 13. This is 13, this must be 13. Okay, now we look at the third was this square. This is 28, we know this is 28. This is 22, so this one should be 6. 6 plus 22 is 28. This is 6, and then this should be also 6 because this is square. This is square. So now this is 6, this is 13, the total is 28. So what is this length? Should be 28 minus 6 minus 13. Okay. 28 minus 6 minus 13 is 9. Okay. If this is 9, and then this must be also 9. Okay. If this is 9, the remaining is, I mean, the length will be 28 minus 9, which is 19. Okay. So the answer is E. Question 20. 9 tokens are black on one side and white on other side. Okay, these are the tokens. Okay, we have 4 black and 5 whites. Initially, 4 tokens have the black and 5 tokens have the white. Okay. In each turn, you have to flip 3 tokens. That means when you flip your chance, when you got a chance, you can flip 3 tokens. Okay. What is the least number of turns you need to have to all tokens showing the same color? When they talk about same color, it can be a white or it can be a black. Okay. So what we do, we just write first. We have a black 3, we have a black 4. Okay, we have a white, and white 5. Okay. So first what I do, if I turn all 3 blacks, it is I cannot solve it in a faster way, faster method. So first what I do, I must mix it up. Okay, at least got black and white. Okay. If I turn 2 black, 1 white, or maybe I return 1 black, 3, 2 white. Okay. So white got a lot. So that is easy to change the black to white. Okay. So what I do, I try to turn these 3 first. Because each turn I can turn 3 tokens. If I want to turn these 3, so I got a black here. Now this one become white. I turn it. This also I turn become white. This one I turn is become black. Okay. So the others all are white. Okay. Now you look at this combination. We have 3 black and 6 white. Okay, this is my first method, my first step. My second step, I can turn 3 and want to make all same color. So I have to turn these 3 black so that it turns to white. Okay, this is already white, this is already white. This black I turn to white, so the other is all white. So by just doing 2 steps, I can turn all the tokens into white. So the answer should be B. Okay, 2. Okay, look at question 25. Sorry, 21. 21. This question is a 5 marks question. Which of the following option will balance the circle? The third scale. Sorry. Okay. So this one, when we see, it is not easy to find or to using any algebra to find the value of each shape. Okay. So what we can do if we wanted to solve it easily. So we know this and this are balancing. This and this are balancing. So that means when I take these 2, I put it here, and I take these 3, I put it here, I can get a balanced scale. Okay. So what I do? Okay, now first this one has 3 box. Okay. Balance with 2 triangle and 1 circle. Now what I do, I take all this one, these 2, I put it here, these 2 I put it here to balance back. Okay, so I put here 1 triangle and 1 arrow. So here what I do, I take 2 circles and 1 box. Okay, so my aim is, I want to get at only 2 box and 1 arrow. That means I only need 2 box, okay, and 1 arrow. That means I have to remove this and this. Okay, when I remove 1 box from here, okay, so I have to remove 1 box from here, then only it will be balanced. And when I remove this triangle, I have to remove this triangle. So now I have 2 box and 1 arrow. So 2 box and 1 arrow is balanced by 3 circle and 1 triangle. So the answer is 3 circle, 1 triangle is C. Okay, question 22. Magnus has to play 15 games in a chess tournament. So, total game he have to play is 15. Okay. At some point during the tournament, he has won half of the game. So, half of, we don't know, maybe this is the one he have to play. Okay. So, he played half of the game. Win, he win half of the game. Okay, and okay, game he win, he won half of the game, and one third, he lost one third of the game, he lost. Okay, and then two games, he draw. Okay, now from this given information. You want to find what is the number of games you have played. Okay, this one you can solve using algebra. Okay, or maybe you can use just normal method. Okay, you see here we got 1 over 2, here we got 1 over 3. Okay, so which number, because this is a number, it's an integer. It cannot be point values because the number of games can be 1, 2, 3, 4, anything under 15. Okay, the number from 0 to 15, which number can divide by 2 and divide by 3? Okay, 1, 2 can divide by 2 but cannot divide by 3. 3 can divide by 3 but cannot divide by 2. That means the suitable number, it can be a 6 because 6 can divide by 2 and also 6 can divide by 3. Okay, 6 divided by 2. If we take 6 as the total number of games he played, and then he win 6 over 2, correct? And then he lost 6 over 3, which will be 2. And then he draw 2 games. So 3 plus 2 plus 2 is 7. So this is not a 6. So 6 cannot be used. The next number which can divide by 2 and divide by, divisible by 2 and divisible by 3. 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, cannot. So only 12. If we take this as a 12, okay, so win must be 12 over 2, 6 games. Lost must be 12 over 3, which is 4 games. And then he draw 2 games. So 6 plus 4 plus 2 is 12. So this is correct. So he played 12 games. So what the question asks you, how many games does Magnus still have to play? So he still have to play 3 games. So answer is B. This is a normal method. I'm not using algebra. So if you want to use algebra, you can use algebra to solve this one. If you use algebra, it will be more easier. Okay? Okay, question 23. So this question I have to do using experimental method. Okay, if you want to solve using normal mathematics, a little bit difficult. Okay, Vadim has a square piece of paper. Let's say this is a paper, he has a square piece. Okay, so what he did, he marked the first column in a gray and then he wrote if this is as a 1. Okay. Then they said what he did, okay, he turned the paper, he okay, paper show the overlapping horizontal and vertically, so the gray squares on top. Okay, he fold the paper first, he fold, okay, he has like this, fold like this. Okay, that means the gray color you can see on top, and then he fold like this. Second one. Then third one, he fold like this and he fold like this. This is what he have done. After fold this, he write the numbers from top to the bottom. Okay, this is the 1. This will be 2. And then down 1. And then this will be 3. Then this will be 4. Where is the 5? Okay, 5. 6. I write 5, 6. This is 7, this is 6, 6, 7, this is, I write as 8, this is I write as 9, only 5 I am able to write. Then when open back, okay, this is 4, this is 8, this is 2, and the middle is 5. So this is what the numbers equal. Okay, from here they say what is A, B and C. So from here we can see our A is 6, okay, B is 4 and C is 8. This is how you have to do. Okay, in the exam hall, if you could get some paper, request paper from your teacher and try to do this. Okay, so the answer should be A 6, B 4, C 8 is A. Answer A. Answer is A. Okay. Question 24. Don builds a pyramid with balls. The square base consists of 3 times 3 balls as shown in the left. The right diagram shows the middle layer of that as 2 times 2 and top is 1. Okay, now he puts glue at each of the contact. Contact is here. He also got contact. He also got contact. And everybody got contact. All the contact he put glue. Okay, now his other question is how many glue points are there? So we go from the bottom on a bottom. We have 9, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So how many places we have here? Okay, here we have a glue 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 places we have glue. Okay, these two, like maybe it's 12. Okay, and then the middle layer, we have 4 balls. Okay, the 4 balls where we have glued, only 1, 2, 3, 4 places. Okay, okay, now when we look at here, okay, the top one, this one touched this 4 at 4 places. Means this single ball is glued at the 4 places, correct? Okay, when we have a 4 here, okay, we have a top here, we got 1. Okay, we got 1 on top here. Means this and this got 1 point of the glue. Here 1, here 1, here 1. Then we have 4 point of glue. The same thing, when we look at this one, this ball will be glued to these 4 balls. This ball will be glued for this 4. Okay. I draw 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. And then second layer, we have this 1, 2, 3, 4. I mean this one ball is glued with this 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. This also 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. We have 16 places where we have glued together. Okay, so I think that's all. So we have to plus all now. 16 plus 12 is 28. 6, 12 plus 4 plus 4 plus 16, which is equal to 36. So answer is this one all you have to imagine.